وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه وعن كل صحابة أجمعين أن رجلا قال لنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أوصني. Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala says that a person came to Nabi Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, awsini, give me a wasiyah, give me an advice. Okay. So always remember, none of us are on the stature of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when in the ahadith, when we are going to look at the ahadith, we are always going to understand it from the Sahaba perspective. Because just as the Sahaba looked up to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are also on the lower scale and we are also looking up to those who are before us, who are more knowledgeable and who are more muqarrab to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should in our life as well, we cannot attain to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't have those miracles and the mujizat and the karamat within ourselves. So what we can do is adopt the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ, that you be along with the sulaha and with the sadiqeen, right? We start looking for those who are closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we can ask them for the mashwara. Just like the sahaba is asking from Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the mashwara. Right, so obviously a person who is already in line with the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with understanding the deen properly and following it on the level of islah zahir wa batin and everything, then such an individual, you can always ask for mashwara. You can always go and say, yes, give me some advice. You know me, so is there anything in me that you want to inform me that I should correct? Right, I should rectify. Don't feel shy about it. Once you have found somebody who has this quality, it's Allah's ni'mat upon you that you can actually approach them and ask these things. So don't miss out on this ni'mah, lest you be counted among the kufranu ni'mah, that you have deprived yourself of the ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the first thing. Sahabi goes to Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam and says, "Awsini," and Sahaba did that a lot. A lot, because Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to live among them, and he used to know them. He used to know about their families. Not like us, we don't even know who our neighbor is or how many kids the neighbor has. All we know is they keep on making noise, right? That's all we know. But no, in their time, they would know that this certain individual, mashallah, he's got kids, but he's going through a hard time. He's a very shadid individual, like harsh person. One sahabiya came to Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asked Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam that I wish to marry, and I wish to marry so and so. So Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, really? Do you wish to marry so and so? So like, yeah, yes, I do wish to marry so and so. So like, may I suggest someone else, because he is very swift with his stick, right? Meaning he's got short temper, and he gets upset very fast. And when he gets upset, then he loses his calm, right? You become his wife. You'll have to get ready for that then, right? So now, other instances, the Sahabiya still wanted to get married and everything, but Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is advising the Sahaba according to what they are looking at, what they are facing. So now look at this. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "La taghdab." His wasiyah or his statement advice is, don't get angry. Imagine you go to Imam Sahab, right? Imam Sahab, give me some advice today. Yeah, don't get angry, man. Right? You're gonna say, like, I'm asking for advice. You're just telling me don't get angry. Right? This is the advice. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he knows the person, he knows the individual, and he knows what's the one thing that he needs to work on the most. Right? So if he's asking for advice, it's the prime time to tell him, you want to work on this element of yours. Right, so Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam giving advice to him, knowing this individual, knowing his ahwal, don't get upset, don't get angry in small things, right? Try to become tolerant about things. فَرَدَّ ذَلِكَ مِرَارًا. The sahabi repeated that multiple times. That maybe, you know, maybe there might be an advice that is more than that, because we have other narrations where sahabi would say, give me an advice, and Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say, la tushrik billah, you know, zidni, right? Increase upon that advice, increase upon that advice, and more advices would keep on coming. So he also said, faradda dhalika miran, meaning oh sini, right, give me advice, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam kept on saying the same thing. qala la taghdab, la taghdab, la taghdab. Meaning that this was perhaps two ways of looking at it. That this was a very big problem that this particular Sahabi had that he needed to work on. So he gave him that advice. Or it could be that this was the only element of Islah left in him, that if he had fixed it, he was already on the higher scale of Ihsan. Right? Bas yehi reh gaya. If you fix this, you are now 100%. Right? Yes.
So it was specific to that Sahabi though, right?
This hadith is specific to the Sahabi. But we are taking a general lesson from it. Right? So, understand, people are going to come and ask you for advice sometimes. MashaAllah, somebody is going to come to Huzaifa and say like, oh, I see the mihrab on your forehead, man. Right? So, please tell me how should I teach my kids. Right? And he's going to say like, man, I got busted my head on something. And that's why I'm... No, but people are going to come and ask for advice, right? Sometimes I always tell, mashallah, the sunnahs of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam have so much power in them, right? You keep a simple beard and people think you are a Sufi, right? You become Molvi, you are an alama, alim, or this, right? Wallahi, people have come to me and they have said that, mashallah, you have a beard, make dua for me. What did the beard have to do with it? Right? Nothing. You don't even know whether the person kept the beard with the intention of the sunnah. But this is the muhabba and this is the qubuliya that Allah has kept even among the sinners. That, oh no, somebody gets a beard, meaning he's closer to Allah. Alright, let's go to him, ask him advice. Right? So if somebody does come to your advice, galti kari di usne, right? if somebody comes to you for advice, then don't turn him away. Right? Oh, man tawada lillah, whoever puts himself down, Allah will raise him. Brother, I am an asi, I am a sinner. I was talking to the girl. You know, you don't need to do all that. Okay? You can make istighfar for all those sins. But now somebody, Allah has sent somebody to you for advice. Then what you do is make yourself mukhatib, make the address to yourself. And if you know something that he needs to know about, genuinely and sincerely know about, then let him know. But make yourself mukhatib. That thing should not come in me. Maybe the person swears a lot. Right? So you tell him, you know, I'm not eligible to give any advice. But what I have been struggling with, maybe you are struggling with it as well. Right? So not to swear a lot, because it a fahash, a person with vulgar language, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam does not like such an individual. Bas, khalas. Right? So do it in a way, put yourself under the bus, right? That I have this problem and you don't need to pinpoint at him, right? And that way you can give the advice. And because you are making yourself mukhatib, work on it as well, sincerely, that I'm not going to swear.
Sorry, what is mukhatib mean?
Address. You address yourself, yeah.